Beauty is in the eye of the beholder, and if the eye is too close to what it happens to be beholding, the thing it's looking at can lose its beauty entirely. Some things can lose their glamour if you get a little bit too close. A too close selfie can be traumatizing enough, let alone looking at someone under a microscope. Insects are kind of ugly as it is, so imagine how intensely hideous they can be under a microscope. These are the most terrifying insects seen from a close distance. Before we begin, make sure to hit the like button, subscribe to our channel, and click the notification bell for more amazing videos every day. With that being said, let's begin. Number 10. Queen Ant. If you have an ant colony in front of you right now, which would be kind of weird, you may be racking your brain to figure out which one is the queen. After all, ants look like ants, and the royal one in the colony isn't scuttling around in a crown and velvet cape with pet corgis by her side. And to be fair, all ants look at least a little bit terrifying when you see them up close. Look a little closer, however, and the queen will show herself eventually. Not only is she far older than the rest, with some queen ants living to be around 30 years old, but she's also a lot bigger than the others. Queen ants tend to require extra bulk to lay their eggs, and the worker ants in the colony also ensure that they are well fed. Queen ants are also identifiable by their enlarged thorax, which is the body area below their neck, and some even have wings. If they don't have wings, however, then they'll have little stumps where those wings may have been, which is quite terrifying to see up close too. If you can't spot the queen amongst the piles of ants, then check out those piles with a magnifying glass. You're sure to find that little worker ants are climbing all over their queen to make sure she's fed and clean. Now it's time for the odd topic. Maggots are already pretty grotesque things. Nobody keeps them as a pet for pretty good reasons, and if you do know someone who does, I promise you that person is not okay. But who would think fly maggots would look even more terrifying? With microscopic technology, we can get a better look at what fly maggots actually look like. And holy crikey, would you look at that thing? It's worse than your mom. Does this image make you hate maggots even more? Comment down below and let us know. As always, comment down below with the hashtag #oddtopic. And to let us know your opinion in relation to what we just showed on screen, let's move on to the next one. Number 9. Scorpion fly. It won't take long for you to work out why the scorpion fly is on this list. Look at it. It's an evolutionary mistake and does some weird stuff as well. The scorpion fly, while harmless, will be displeasing to the eye up close. It has a strange snout, a scorpion-like tail without the painful bits, and an extended abdomen. Oddly enough, the tip of their stomach is also the male's genitalia. If that wasn't weird enough, then this little insect has a few strange habits. It steals from spider webs, and uses its tail in fights with other males, and offers up dead insects and blobs of saliva as gifts for lady friends. Oh, you shouldn't have. The scorpion fly is easy to spot when you're out and about, too. Take note of its black and yellow body, red head, strange long beak, and a few patches on its wings. Try not to recoil in horror. Number 8. Bedbug. If someone tells you to sleep tight and don't let the bedbugs bite, then thank them for their kind words, and pray that that ritualistic saying keeps you safe. You really don't want a bedbug to bite you. These little insects feed off blood, and are not fussy about whether it's yours or an animal's. It also prefers to make its move when you're sleeping, kind of like Santa Claus, but without the gifts. Bedbugs thrive in almost any environment, but prefer bedrooms, where they can bunker down in mattresses and your dresser drawers. They pierce your skin, drink your blood through their strange-looking beak, then return to their hiding spot. When you get up close and personal with a bedbug, not that you'll want to, you'll notice its skin-piercing parts of the mouth and 6 joined legs with small microscopic hairs. When they are empty of blood, they are brown and flat, but when they've made someone their victim, they are fat and red. If it wasn't enough that they had to make you itchy, they also had to look fiercely unattractive up close while they did it as well. Number 7. False-a-day. False-a-day, also known as daddy long legs, are the insects of your nightmares. Their bodies are the shape of a peanut, but their legs are ridiculously long, around 2 inches each. They can't help but send shivers up your spine when they scuttle along your walls or floors. These spider-like creatures, which people also call cellar spiders, are not going to win beauty contests anytime soon. When you see them up close, you'll be terrified by the sight of their 6 to 8 eyes, arranged into 2 groups. If that's not enough to make you recoil in horror, then the fact that some of their heads are transparent might just do the trick. False-a-day are also divided into 1,800 species, which are found everywhere in the world, except for Antarctica. So if you want to ensure that you don't see them, then it's time to put on your best snow boots and head off to the coldest part of the globe. Number 6. House centipede. We don't know why these insects are called house centipedes, because they are certainly not welcome in our abodes looking like that. house centipedes, with a complicated scientific name of Scutigera coleoptrata, are yellow and gray insects with 15 pairs of legs. It can be hard enough trying to find a decent pair of jeans for two legs, let alone 30 in total. While the house centipede originally came from the Mediterranean region, it spread around the world and popped up in people's homes, which is how it got its name of house centipede. If you were brave enough to check out this insect up close, you might actually be quite impressed by its body structure. Aside from its dozens of legs, which can carry it to speeds of 0.4 meters per second, it also has three dorsal stripes on its body and dark stripes on its legs. Some of their legs have also mutated to look like antennae, which is a little bit weird. Even though house centipedes are terrifying to look at, they're relatively harmless unless you're an insect. They are active hunters and enjoy devouring flies and cockroaches. We were led to believe that cockroaches can survive almost anything, but it turns out that house centipedes cover that almost category quite well. So, in conclusion, yuck. Number 5. Pus caterpillar. The pus caterpillar, or southern flannel moth as it's also known, is a terrifying insect that you can't help but want to see up close. It's clearly a love-hate relationship with this insect. On the one hand, you'll want to find out more about the weird fur that covers this caterpillar, but on the other, you'll want to stay well clear of it. The pus caterpillar, which gets its name from its fur-like coat, kind of like a pussycat, is one of the most poisonous caterpillars in the world. It was nature's cruel joke to give this caterpillar fur you can't help but want to touch, but make it incredibly painful if you give in to temptation. If you do accidentally touch the fur of a pus caterpillar, you will see it's not fluffy at all, but venomous spines that cause blisters, burns, swelling, and even nausea. The spines are hollow, with venom glands along the base of each spine. If you get too close to the pus caterpillar, you'll need to remove the spines from your skin as soon as possible. Number 4. Silverfish. Do you eat sugar, starch, carbs, and flop about like a fish? Your spirit animal might be a silverfish. The silverfish is an ancient wingless insect that has scales and a tapered abdominal section that makes it look a little bit like a fish. It's silver and gray, a bit shiny, and has two searchy as well as two small eyes. Other members of the silverfish family have no eyes, so this species got lucky. If it's not the disturbing features of this insect that make you throw up in your mouth a little bit, then it's their diet and weird mating ritual that will. Firstly, they don't dine purely on insects as others do. Instead, they prefer to roam your house, on the lookout for delicious crumbs or other sugary and starchy goodies. Some even eat glue, leather, and paper. When they mate, you'll want to avert your attention away, because it gets a little bit weird. Male and female stand facing each other and allow their quivering antennae to touch. They then quickly back off from each other. The male runs away, while the female silverfish takes up chase. They then stand side by side, head to tail, while the male vibrates his tail against the female's. He then lays a sperm capsule, which the female takes to fertilize her eggs. Okay, moving along. Number 3. Bullet ant. Think about the most terrifying horror film you ever saw, then look at the bullet ant. You'll soon realize that what you thought was terrifying was basically the Care Bears. The bullet ant up close will send feelings of disgust shooting through your body, and if it doesn't, you're some kind of monster. This insect is dark brown, a little bit hairy, covered in legs, and has two piercing little eyes that make you want to scratch your own out. If its looks up close aren't enough to make you run screaming from the room, then what it can do to you will. If it stings you, which it probably will if you touch it, then you may as well run over burning coals for relief. According to etymologists, being stung by a bullet ant can feel like you've been shot, which is where the name aptly comes from. In fact, etymologist Dr. Justin Schmidt likened the sting of a bullet ant to walking over flaming charcoal with rusty nails in your heels. Sounds lovely. So the bullet ant is both ugly and horrifyingly painful to touch. Number 2. Cave whip spiders. Also known as nope by most people, the cave whip spider, or tailless whip scorpion, is one of the most terrifying insects to look at from any distance in the world. From their broad, flat bodies and eight eyes to their thin legs and raptorial pedipalps for grabbing their prey, these insects are weird. They even use their front pair of legs as antennae, while their spindly little legs look like whips. When they find something tasty to eat, fortunately not humans, they use their antennae-like legs as giant spears to impale and immobilize their prey. If they were any bigger and had a taste for human blood, the human race would be toast. Number 1. Screwfly. If you're particularly squeamish, then look away. The screwfly is going to make your body eject your lunch without all too much effort. The screwfly, or New World screwworm as it's also known, is a man-eater. It might look small and disgusting up close, but it can actually do a lot of damage for its size. An adult female screwfly will lay its eggs on its victim, generally near a wound or by a baby animal's new belly button. As the eggs hatch, the disgusting-looking larvae use their sharp little jaws and fangs to gnaw their way into their host's skin. The maggots then drill their way into bone, muscle, nerves, anything they can wrap their laughing gear around. While humans aren't their first choice, there have been cases of screwfly babies living inside people's heads. Take Rochelle Harris, a British tourist, for example. She went to the doctor because she heard scratching in her head and was experiencing pain. As it turns out, maggots had burrowed 1 centimeter into her head. Sleep well tonight, kids. You wouldn't want to meet any of these insects in a dark alley, with a magnifying glass, of course. Was there any insect that looked scarier than the others? What insects are you scared of? It can be hard to show these little critters any love when they look like they do. Also, check out our other cool stuff showing up on screen now. See you next time. See you.